this video, I will show how to resolve the given forces into its horizontal and vertical components, and how to find the resultant force and the angle made by the resultant force along horizontal axis. Consider a figure as shown. In this figure, there are different forces which are acting along different directions, which we have to resolve into their components and find the net force acting along the horizontal and vertical axis, that is along x axis and y axis. And then we will find the resultant of these net vertical and horizontal forces and its direction. This concept we will understand in detail with 4 steps. Step 1. Resolving all the forces into horizontal and vertical components. Step 2. Calculating net horizontal and net vertical force due to this horizontal and vertical components of forces. Step 3. Finding the resultant force due to this net horizontal and vertical forces. Step 4. Finding the direction or angle made by the resultant force with horizontal axis. So without wasting much of your time, I will start solving this. I will start with step 1. Step 1. Resolving all the forces into horizontal and vertical components. Before we jump onto resolving all these forces from the figure, we will first see how to resolve a single individual force into its component along horizontal and vertical axis. We can take any individual force. In this case, I will take a force from the same above figure and resolve it into its component. To resolve the forces into its components, I will take force P, which is making an angle of 60 degree with x axis or horizontal axis. Now, how to resolve these forces into its component? Before resolving this force, we will understand what resolving the forces into its component exactly means. Resolving a force into its components means to calculate the amount of force acting along horizontal and vertical axis because of this inclined force P or any other inclined force. Now, since we knew the proper meaning of resolving any force into its component, let us start resolving this force P into its components along horizontal and vertical axis. I will denote horizontal and vertical components of force P with Px and Py respectively. Here we can see force P, which is 700 N, is making an angle of 60 degree with horizontal axis, which means the angle made by the force P with vertical axis is equal to 30 degree. Horizontal component Px will be equal to force P multiplied by cos of angle made by the force P with x axis or horizontal axis along which the component of the force is to be found out. And here we can see P is making an angle of 60 degree with horizontal axis. Therefore, Px will be equal to force P multiplied by cos of 60 degree. After putting the values of force P and multiplying with cos 60, we will get Px, which is horizontal component of force P, is equal to 350 N. Here, there is another way to find the horizontal component Px is to multiply force P with sine of the angle made by the force P with the axis which is perpendicular to the axis along which the component of force is to be found out. This simply means multiplying force P with sine of angle made by the force P with vertical or y axis. Here, angle made by the force P with y axis is equal to 30 degree. Therefore, horizontal component Px will also be equal to P multiplied by sine 30. After putting the values of force P and multiplying with sine 30, we will get Px, which is horizontal component of P, is equal to 350 N. Therefore, we can see whichever way we do, if we take the angle made by the force properly, we will end up getting correct value for horizontal component. Now, I will find vertical component of force P, which I will denote as Py. Like how we did for horizontal component Px, similarly here also the vertical component Py will be equal to force P multiplied by cos of angle made by the force P with y axis or vertical axis along which the component of the force is to be found. That is, force P multiplied by cos of 30 degree. After putting the values of force P and multiplying with cos 30, we will get Py is equal to 606.21 Newton. Or another way to find the vertical component Py is to multiply force P with sine of angle made by the force P with the axis which is perpendicular to the vertical component is to be found. This simply means multiplying force P with sine of angle made by the force P with horizontal or x-axis. Py will also be equal to P multiplied by sine of 60. After putting the values of force P, which is 700 Newton, and multiplying with sine of 60, we will get Py, which is vertical component of force P, is equal to 606.21 Newton. Therefore, here also in both the cases, we end up getting same value of vertical component. Since now we understood how to resolve the individual force into its horizontal and vertical component, similarly, we can do for all other forces which are shown in the figure. Now quickly, I will do for all other forces. For force R, which is 30 Newton and making an angle of 40 degree with horizontal axis. To find horizontal component of R, which I will denote as Rx, Rx will be equal to force R multiplied by cos of 40 degree. After putting the values of R and solving, we will have Rx equal to 229.8 Newton. To find vertical component of R, which I will denote as Ry, Ry will be equal to R multiplied by sine of 40 degree. After putting the values of R and simplifying, we will have Ry equal to 192.83 Newton. Similarly, we will do for force X, which is 100 Newton and making an angle of 60 degree with x-axis. To find horizontal component of S, which I will denote as Sx, Sx will be equal to S multiplied by cos of 60. After putting the value of S and simplifying, we will get Sx equal to 50 Newton. To find vertical component of S, which I will denote as Sy, Sy will be equal to S multiplied by sine of 60. After putting the values of S and simplifying, we will get Sy equal to 86.6 Newton. And for the last force T, which is 200 Newton, making an angle of 35 degree with horizontal axis. To find the horizontal component of force T, which I will denote as Tx, Tx will be equal to force T multiplied by cos of 35 degree. After putting the values of force T and simplifying, we will get Tx equal to 163.83 Newton. And to find vertical component of T, which I will denote as Ty, Ty will be equal to T multiplied by sine of 35 degree. After putting the values of T and simplifying, we will get Ty equal to 57.35 Newton. Since we already resolved all the forces into their vertical and horizontal component, now we almost finished understanding the major part. Next, we will jump on to step 2. Which is very simple. In fact, all the remaining steps are very simple. Step 2. Calculate net vertical and horizontal force due to this horizontal and vertical component of forces. To get net horizontal force due to all horizontal components, we have to sum up all the horizontal components of forces which we just found. And to get net vertical force due to all vertical components, we have to sum up all the vertical components of forces which we found. Now, while summing up horizontal forces, here we have to keep in mind all the forces which are acting along left side are to be taken negative and all the forces which are acting on the right side are to be taken positive. Therefore, net horizontal force, which I will denote as HF, will be equal to EX plus RX plus SX plus TX. Now, put the values. HF equal to PF, which is 350 Newton, positive because it is acting along right side. RX equal to minus 229.8, negative because it is acting along left side. Sx equal to minus 50 because it is acting along left side. Tx equal to 162.83 newton positive because it is acting along right side. After simplifying, we will get Hf equal to 234.03 newton. To find net vertical force, we have to sum up all the vertical component of the forces. While doing this, for vertical component, we have to keep in mind all the forces which are acting upward are to be taken positive and all the forces which are acting downward are to be taken negative. To find net vertical force, which I will denote as Vf, which will be equal to Py plus Ry plus Sy plus Ty. Now to put the values, Vf equal to Py, which is 606.21 newton. Here Py is positive because it is acting in upward direction. Ry equal to 192.83. Here it is positive because it is also acting in an upward direction. Sy, which is equal to minus 86 newton, negative because it is acting in downward direction. Ty equal to minus 57.35 newton, negative because it is acting in downward direction. After simplifying, we will get net vertical force Vf equal to 655.09 newton. Therefore, we found out the net horizontal and vertical forces due to sum of horizontal and vertical components respectively. They will be 90 degrees to each other because both are acting along horizontal and vertical axis respectively. Now, step 3, finding out resultant force due to this net horizontal and vertical force. The resultant force of this net horizontal and vertical forces, which I will denote as Rf, will be equal to root of net horizontal force Hf square plus net vertical force Vf square. Therefore, after substituting the values of Hf and Vf, we will have Rf equal to root of 234.03 square plus 655.09 square, which will be equal to 695.64 newton. And the last step, which is step 4, is to find out the direction or angle made by the resultant force Rf with horizontal axis, which can be calculated by using trigonometric formula, which says tan theta equal to opposite side upon adjacent side. Here opposite side is equal to Vf, which is equal to 655.09 newton, and adjacent side will be equal to Hf, which is 234.03 newton. Therefore, after substituting the values of Vf and Hf, we will get theta equal to tan inverse of 655.09 divided by 234.03, which is equal to 70.6 degree. So in this video, we saw how to resolve the forces into their component, find the net horizontal and vertical force due to this component, to find the net resultant force, and last, how to find the angle made by the resultant force. So friends, hope you have understood all the 4 steps. If you find this video useful, like and share with your friends. And if you truly want to understand all the concepts clearly, click on the subscribe button below and turn on the notification to get all my awesome videos. Thank you for watching.